everyone, this is CJ Novo 992. And today we are back for another brand new video. Now, lads, the football is back. It's finally back. The weeks of boredom and pre-season friendlies are gone. It matters now, lads. It freaking really matters. And we won. 3 points. Yes. I'm going to try to keep this video a wee bit shorter to experiment to see what you guys like, if you prefer like the longer videos or the short ones. You guys will let me know down below, but before we get into today's video, tell them what it is.
Hello! Hey folks, I'm WWE Hall of Famer Hacksaw Jim Duggan, and nothing gets me through the day like a piece of CJ Nova 992. Smash the like button with a 2x4 and subscribe!
Thank you. Another legend on the channel, that's what I bring to you guys. You set likes, you drop comments, I get legends, that's how it happens. Today, obviously, we bet Motherwell at Fir Park 2-1. Two goals from Durans, I believe his name is. I believe he's French or some kind of Spanish descent, Ubi Durans. Looks like a tidy little player. You know, I was making jokes on Twitter and people actually started correcting me, thinking I didn't know it was Durans. Come on, lads, alright? Alright, you kind of cut this clip to make me look like a dick, okay? I know it's Durans, right? Right, I better address myself before it's... YouTuber doesn't know who Durans is. Huh, supposed to be a Rangers fan, eh? 2-1, two goals for Durans. I maybe should have picked him for my player of the season. I'm still going with Jack. And that's where I wanted to move on to, because I think the partnership between Durans and Jack is absolutely fantastic. Now, Durans will steal a lot of the headlines, but if you're looking for breaking up, I thought Jack done that. But it's not just that, it seems to be they're always in sync. Now, you see like pundits and that talking about midfield players when they're in the centre, they need to be close to each other. I find like one of the shining examples of that is when Dembele and when Yama play for Tottenham, they're always exactly the same like that. And Rangers look like they've got two people that knows exactly where each other are going to be the entire time. They cover for each other, they protect each other. When one pushes forward, the other one drops in. And it's very tidy partnership and I think a very underrated combo. I'm seeing a lot of people already addressing certain players. I just wanted to give them a wee thumbs up. Moving on to the next player I want to talk about today. We have Lewis Moult. Obviously, Rangers legend. Done really, really well for Rangers today. Obviously, clearing a goal-scoring opportunity for Motherwell. Like, open net, he made sure it didn't go in. A couple of elbows thrown in there, giving us free kicks. A lot of chances to get the ball in the box, which was really, really tidy. Fighting away with the defence. Obviously, pushing away and winning as a penalty, which was very nice. Thank you. Thank you, Moulty. And even almost got yourself sent off, which was nice. Just to give us a wee bit more grip of the game, giving him a clear opportunity for one of our free kick takers to try and attempt on target, but we didn't do that. And then at the end, in the 92nd minute, there was a person refusing to give the ball back. I don't know if you saw it. There's a lot of controversy, a lot of stewards and everything, a lot of boos. That was actually Lewis Moulty in the stands, refusing to give the ball back to Motherwell just to give Rangers the win. So shout out to Moulty as well, played really, really tidy in his professional debut for Rangers. Look forward to him seeing him maybe in the blue next week. Next player I want to talk about is Joshy Windass, aka Bangle Boy. He's no Aaron Bangle, man. Now, to be fair to Windass, I think he started off pretty well. He had a terrible, terrible cross when Candias was wide open, but he didn't actually manage to connect there. But I thought the rest of the first half, he was absolutely fantastic. Bale-esque. I believe someone put that on Twitter as well. Like, cutting in, shooting, going down the left. Either foot, he was tidy. Unlucky with a beautiful, beautiful curl shot first to hit the post. And then when it went to 1-1, obviously had the opportunity to hit the post as well. I think it's fair to say God hates Josh Windass, but I certainly don't. Second half sort of petered out, but again, he'd done some nice touches. He got shifted over to the right in the first half, which was I thought was a key mistake by Pedro, because literally was red hot on form on the left. But then because Hodgson was playing so terribly, they put him over to the right just to try and protect him a little bit, and it didn't really work out. It sort of faded him. Anyone else I want to talk about? Oh yeah, our fucking fullbacks. Oh, fullbacks. Jesus H Christ, what the fuck was that? Hodgson, utter garbage. The miscommunications with Candias, constantly the entire first half. He was just wanting Candias to do everything. He was like, you Chiras, you check. He's like, no, you Hodgson, you fucking defend. Moving on to Wallace. Come on, lads, everybody do it. Do it while you hit the like button. Then you re-hit the like if you're... Never worry about it. Wallace. Oh, I'm just the one to get in here. I tried to give him a fair chance, lads. You saw it on Twitter. I was trying to just get behind them, but fuck me, can the guy no defend? Like, honestly, he just can't defend. I'm just so tired of it. Yes, he stayed with us, but God, he can't defend. There was four different occasions I put on Twitter. Watch Wallace. Not once did he look at, I think it was number 5 that was playing for Motherwell. He just kept running in behind Wallace every time they had, like, Hodgson was just letting him run down the right-hand side to cross the ball. And Wallace just didn't even look behind him, had no idea a player was there. Thankfully, the crosses were shit, so we got away with it. Jogging back. But again, what you get with Wallace, fantastic going forward. Like, unbelievably, links the play, does everything, gets the ball, creates havoc. But when you're a left-back, defend first. Defend should always be the first, like, mindset of a player. Then you can attack. So if we're comfortable, attack. If not, sit back. It just goes so freaking early. It's like, you're already pushed up front? Wow, okay. Now, I'm not going to try and get too doom and gloom, obviously, at win, but the fullback situation, lads, I just want to tell you that needs to be addressed really, really quickly, because it's absolutely terrible. Against a better side, like the Celtics and stuff like that, I know Aloy's got high expectations for the season, but we would absolutely get teared apart, because the fullback situation is still a joke. The rest of it, though, happy. We've got the win. Yeah, let's jump over to the poll. Let's see what you guys are thinking down below. In fact, before we get to the poll, I'm a wee bit thirsty. Are you guys thirsty? Yeah, I can hear it. Kurt Angle, tell them what to do.
Squish fizzy beer down your necks on the sponsor break. Oh, it's true. It's damn true.
Thank you, Kurt. Sponsor break. And we're back. Let's get to the tweet. I don't think the actual poll's even finished, lads, but like I said, got a lot of stuff today. This is going to take a couple of hours to edit. I want you guys to see it. So I put it up for 30 minutes. It's still got 11 minutes to go, but there's already been 205 votes, so I'd greatly appreciate that. Thank you for all the support on there as well. I put Man of the Match, post your recaps down below, and I'll read them out in today's video. Oh, I fucked up another poll. Right, I put Fod's got 6% of the votes, followed by Molt, who got 7% of the vote. Windass, surprisingly, only got 18%, but 69% of the vote was Durance, the French international. Absolutely not surprising, to be honest with you. I thought, yeah, I played a tremendous game. I can't really argue with that. I would have liked to have seen Windass get a wee bit more recognition, because I thought he was absolutely fantastic in that first half, but you can't really complain. Win's a win. Happy with that. And if you're watching on YouTube just now, post your Man of the Match down below. I'll speak to you guys in the comments. That's why I make the videos. I always say that. I reply to nearly every tweet. I still reply to nearly every comment. I believe I'm the only YouTuber that actually bothers to reply to subscribers. I still reply, and I get hundreds of comments now. Takes a while. Right, let's jump out right to the very first tweet and let's see what's going on. Jim Walls at JWNovo992. Thank you, buddy. Brilliant game for Dorans. Jack, partnership was... Oh, yeah, you noticed it as well. Nice. Shout out to Mo through positive play, but we can't just keep slipping off after 60 minutes. Bruno and Fabio, once again, were showing their class. Hodgson and Jogger were shite as pair, but Bangle put in a brilliant first half. Thank you, Novo. RFC reviews at NovoNation_1. Thank you, buddy. Dorrance was the man of the match. Bang a boy, a close second, but a great start. Bring on the Hibs. Dorrance, one of his own. Also wrote, our midfield and defence is a lot better than last season, but it all depends on if we can be arsed to show up. This is a must this season. Matthew Taylor, the channel legend. Thank you, Matty. Well played. We just need to take chances at goal and score, because this sitting panicking at every chance at Motherwell isn't okay. Agreed. Another channel legend. I like it, lads. We're getting a mere consistency. Yes, I do know every one of my name of the channel legends. That's why they're channel legends. Mark Menzies, at Barry Allen 1698. Great, got to be Dons for me. Good start, but shaky at points. But at least we didn't draw away Hamilton at home this time. Yeah, so sorry about that. Look at them, 123, at Cairo K123. Barrett Mick. Oh, somebody kill me, please! Delighted to get all 3 points. Windass played great game. One man of the match onto goes to Dorrance onto Dunfermline next. David Toner at David_Toner. Dorrance had a class debut. Same with Windass. Windass played more on the left back than Wallace, I know. I'm trying to no read out the Wallace bad comments, because I didn't want it like certain Facebook pages to make me look like I hate Rangers players. Jack Hamilton at Jack Hamilton 203. Great win to start off the season. Thought Dorrance, Windass and Alves were fantastic today. Bring on next week. I completely agree about what Bruno, by the way. I forgot to actually mention. He looked very, very tidy. And he seemed to win every single ball in the air. Played a key part of our goal as well. So did Herrera, to be honest with you. Not the best performance, but glad to get the win at the back of the season. Banger boy over Mackay. Why does my camera always freeze on me? Is it because I cheap out and bought a wee cheap shitty one? Also, just to say, Camon, you're also a channel legend. Matty Taylor, you're also a channel legend. And Scott Young, you're also a channel legend. Conor Crawford, Doran's definitely man in match was alright, even Barry McCann. I want to die. It's Lewis, he's one of our own. He's one of our own. Graham Dons, he's one of our own. Let's just check. This worker from Tetraplic, did your boy? At Steven Celtic 81. What happened to Windass? Unplayable for the first 20 minutes, then Pedro seemed to change his position. Disappeared, unconvincing win. Yeah, I agree. It was kind of weird. Like I mentioned in my actual review, he started off amazing. Then Pedro put him on the right to protect Hodgson. And then he just fell off, which was disappointing. Rebecca McCauley played really well. Dons was my man in the match. VPN Rangers at VPN underscore Rangers. Well, played well at times, but were on the back foot for the patches of the match. Windass, Dorrance and Condozo stood out. Yeah, completely agree. Fabio played absolutely amazing. I'm actually going to just end the recap there because the video is getting a wee bit too long. And yeah, if you're still watching just now, how do you feel about the length of the videos? Obviously, I'm trying to improve the channel and see what you guys like. Do you want short videos, like under 10 minutes? Do you want longer videos? Let me know. I'll try and make it to be the best. I thought Cardozo, Wes, Fods. That's the same person. Bruno, I meant. Windass, Jack, Dorrance, Herrera played okay in patches, won a lot of the knockdowns, a wee bit the unsung hero, got kicked a lot. They were my standouts today, the rest of them got a lot to prove. Yeah, but that's it. Video's done. That was easy. I've been TGNovo92, make sure to be smashing that like button if you enjoyed today's video. Thank you for watching, and bye-bye.